Wow, that is so cool.
Wow.
You want to see the coolest things about this orchid here that we found out after looking at it? See how this is not a flower.
Oh my gosh.
This is a kind of a bract here. I just can't imagine what it's doing here.
It's an amazing place. It's a, we call it our Cypress Cathedral.
Whoop. There's that same hole I fell into before.
You never learn, do you, dear?
No. You're here in our trailer in the community of Pine Island, where the volunteers and the rangers and other support people live. And we are here in the Everglades National Park during winter or the dry season. You know, usually what I do is I take the plant and I pose it here in the studio. Studio, you could maybe not call it a studio. So then I make the drawing and then turn with a light table, I turn it into an ink rendering. The cowhorn orchid will probably take me six weeks to 2 months to do in watercolor. It is a process of just deeper and deeper observation. Try to get some close-up, some real studies of the different elements. So in here we have the pseudobulbs and the flowers, and a look inside to see what the parts of the flower, you know, the sexual parts. This is the capsule. Looking at the leaves of the orchid, trying to get a realistic representation of the actual plant, but in small. Because I'm going to have to go back and just, you know, reconstruct it in a way that's going to be useful for the people that are looking at it, and not too wildly crazy for me to draw.
Clean?
Yeah.
Look at this. The little hole fast.
Yeah.
They're almost kind of a gold color.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, but you don't see those on the
no,
bigger ones.
On the bigger ones. Yeah. Just on the little ones, that's because they're just getting attached. Yeah.
What are you guys looking at?
These are
Tillandsias.
They're air plants.
They're called few-leaved air plants.
When they get big, they get completely underneath the rough bark.
Okay, cool. All right, I'm sketching now.
Okay. Sketch away.
The story is, my mother always told me that I couldn't draw a straight line. I took a botanical watercolor class at Fairchild, and I liked it. You get a good teacher like I have, and that teacher will say, no, you don't draw the plant as you see it. You draw it as you want others to perceive it. So after I make those sketches, then I'll photograph the plant, and I'll photograph it intensively, because a lot of times when I reconstruct the plant, I will do it from the photographs. So after the photographs and the sketching, then we take everything back, and I assemble all of this, and I begin the composition process. And then I sit down and I do the botanical, the actual watercolors. No spores yet. There should be.
They might have a fruiting body. I don't know.
I think a spore is starting. They're really cool.
But look at that. the new fern coming out there. Yeah. Look at this fig growing out of here.
We're just
isn't that wild? Look, it's gonna strangle us.
Yeah.
Another gopher. They're everywhere. I never noticed them so much before.
Something about the Everglades called to our hearts. Every year that we come back, we find out something new. And we just keep learning. So I think that's why it is. It's so complex. There's so many levels. And of course now with me being able to do art, that's a whole other level that's been really wonderful.
We came here at the end of November, and next year we'll be here at the beginning of November.
Because I've got an art show in the co-visitor center.